Not gonna lie, we've been a little short on content in the past couple days. I've been swamped, Justin's been sick, just a lot going on lately. And then we got to thinking, it's been a while since we've done one of these videos. That's right, the future. The first episode of the 2023 season is back, and what a way to kick it off by doing Red Sox prospect Zidane Rafaela. Rafaela is a prospect in the Red Sox organization that really took minor league baseball by storm last year, kind of coming by nowhere and haven't really been heard of. We were going to do a guy like Shane Drohan, but again, we wanted to wait until Drohan maybe, you know, breaks out a little more and the name is kind of more heard. So we're going to go with Rafaela today. A lot of you have heard the name Zidane Rafaela, but after today's video, we're going to make sure that you never forget the name Zidane Rafaela if you didn't know it or even if you just knew it a little bit. So enjoy the future, Zidane Rafaela. Keep in mind, this is the first future video we're doing under our new kind of style, no script, so it's just kind of going to be me going off of what I know and me reading, you know, off of some sites here. But the Red Sox acquired Zidane Rafaela as an international free agent in July of 2017, which would make Rafaela around 17 years old when the Red Sox signed him, sorry. Rafaela stands at 5'9", he's 145 pounds, and he bats and throws from the right side. Don't let that height and weight fool you, because this kid is electric. Zidane, Chipper, Nicasio, Marte, Rafaela. What a name. Rafaela really didn't make it to the Red Sox kind of single-A system until 2021. And before that, he was in rookie ball, the FCL League, low-A, all of those places, like the Gulf League and Lowell and places like that. But in 2018, Rafaela hit for 271 average, 3 home runs, 28 RBIs, struck out a decent amount, walked a decent amount. An all right rookie year. In 2019, he spent time with Lowell and in the Gulf Coast. In the Gulf Coast, he did all right. Was walking about half the amount of times he was striking out. 6 homers, 17 RBIs. Got promoted to Lowell for the final 3 games of the 2019 season. Hit 182, but again, it was 3 games. It was 12 plate appearances. We're not going to rag him on that at all. Like, it's tough to judge. But the real start of Rafaela's career came in 2021 when he started the year in Salem. And then his career just kind of took off from there. As many of you probably know, something happened in 2020, and as a result of that, Rafaela didn't have a season. Rafaela took back up on the field in 2021 where he played for Salem, and in 102 games, he hit for a 251 average, 10 home runs, 53 RBIs, 25 walks, 79 strikeouts, and a 305 on-base percentage. Rafaela also stole 23 bases in those 102 games in Salem. It was a pretty good season for Rafaela, but the hype of Zidane Rafaela really picked up in 2022 when he started the year in Greenville, but quickly found himself playing for the Portland Sea Dogs. And when I say quickly, I mean quickly. In 2022, Zidane Rafaela started the season in Greenville in High A, and in 45 games in Greenville, he hit for a 330 average, 9 home runs, 36 RBIs, 10 walks, 51 strikeouts, a 368 on-base percentage, and he stole 14 bases in those games in Greenville. So not to mention, he has plus defense at center field and even shortstop. Rafaela was then promoted to Portland for the end of the 2022 season, and he played 71 games there, where he hit for a 278 average, hit 12 home runs, 50 RBIs, a 324 on base percentage, 16 walks, and 62 strikeouts. He's not a big walk guy, but as we'll get there, dude has speed to kill, and he plays great defense, and don't let his frame fool you, he can hit the ball. In 2022 in total, he hit 21 home runs, 86 RBIs, hitting for a 300 average, stealing 28 bases. This kid showed some flashes, and he's only continued that so far in 2023. In 2023 so far with the Portland Sea Dogs, Zidane Rafaela has played in 29 games, and so far in 2023, he hit for a 265 average, hit 1 home run, drove in 17 runs, reached base at a 310 clip, 7 walks, 29 strikeouts, but the big number to look at here, 20 stolen bases, including what? I think it was a 6 or 7 stolen base game the other day, followed up by a 3 stolen base game the very next day. So in the span of 2 days, Zidane Rafaela had stolen 9 bases. Not to mention his elite glove, his plus speed, his good hit tool. This guy is going to be great, and he's a shortstop and center fielder. Don't let the frame fool you. Zidane Rafaela is the future. As for an ETA for Rafaela, I would say it's very unlikely that you're going to see him on the major league club this year. So I think sometime next year is very realistic considering he's still in Double A Portland. I think the hope should be to get him up into Worcester by the end of the season at least. So Rafaela gets promoted mid-season to Worcester, hopefully, finishes the season in Worcester, starts next year in Worcester, and then ideally by June, maybe even May or June of next year, we could potentially see a Zidane Rafaela call-up to the Boston Red Sox, where we could see this kid really, really shine for once and all. How does he fit the team, you may ask? Good question. Shortstop and center field are pretty much both kind of taken by the Red Sox right now, with Jarren Duran kind of establishing himself in center field and Trevor Story more than likely moving to shortstop. So it's really unclear how the Red Sox are going to use Sedan Rafaela yet, but that's not my job to figure out. That's not your job to figure out. That's on the team management. That's on Chaim Bloom. And I'm sure the Red Sox will obviously figure out what to do with this kid, because this kid's got too much talent and too much potential to not be used. And again, like I said, I'm just glad it's not my job to figure out what to do with him. So I'm here for a reason. You're watching this video for a reason. Let's let management do management. Let's just sit back and enjoy the show of Sedan Rafaela. And that's it. I hope you guys are all excited for Sedan Rafaela as I am. This kid is really good, and I feel like he's still not being talked about enough. He's 22, probably going to be up in the bigs at 23 or 24, and he's just so good. But anyways, if you guys like this video, feel free to hit that like button, share the video, comment on what other videos you'd like to see us make, and most importantly, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on awesome videos like these. You know the drill. There's going to be a few links in the description of this video, our Twitter, our TikTok, our podcast, all of that good stuff. Make sure you tell us, go to our Twitter, send us a tweet. What do you want us to do for videos? Because we need some ideas. We need your help. We wouldn't be where we are without you guys. So we want your guys' help here. Help us choose some videos here, boys. But until next time, we'll see you guys next. This is Noah from Grandstand Productions. Be good. And I'm out. Go Sox.
I'm gonna tell you a story. I'm gonna tell you about